position, hand fighting with the opposite hand. Right here. Nobody was really working that because you guys are drilling with each other. You're doing what I'm asking you. That's great. This happens a lot, okay? There's things you can do from here. If you're a long guy, you're very flexible, and he's tired of being lazy, especially from core position, he can knee Adrian in the head, okay? There's all sorts of body, whatever. There's lots of things, but let's talk about the throw, okay? There's a different type of committal from here that I want to see. I do not want both hips at Corey's Wizard. I don't want him to put both hips in front of Adrian to throw. No, not even old school wrestling. Just trying to say both butt cheeks across his butt to throw with him. Okay? We can do that. Okay? Now, my preference is not this. We can do it and be explosive. That's awesome. Okay? What happens is, though, is if he's not locked down real tight, he can start to lose and he'll slip out. Or, if he's still kind of here, Adrian can sink hips as he does it. Slip out. Okay? That can happen in anything. But if we're here, preferably, and just as more quick and just as explosive, if he gets just his left ass cheek across Adrian's hip and then chops the thigh and throws, go ahead and pull through. Boom, there's one inside chop. He can throw that absolutely. The other one straight across the thigh. Very explosive. He's going to get his butt cheek crushing, that thigh goes right there, and he's going to kick it and throw. Now, come back up. Here's the deal about it. Committing your hips is something you almost have to do to throw, right? We talk about filling that space with our hips when we throw a lot of things. Or if you're the old school wrestler throw guys, you fill it with something. That space has to go in order to elevate the throw. Without committing forward all the way across, we still get a very explosive, great throw, but let's go back locked up again. If Corey goes to kind of step in front throwing, Adrian's got good balance and sinks, Corey just resets. He works back out. If Corey commits all the way across and loses the Wizard with both hips and so like that, he's way out. It's kind of hard to reset, isn't it? Okay? Possible still to throw it, but difficult. Also, if you notice, what are they playing across? What's the control mechanism here? Okay. Right there. Yes, they're hand fighting. They got to watch to be throwing knees in, uppercutting each other, and everything else. Something else both guys can do, especially when tired, we're not working this right now, we're going to work into it, is just cross knee pick. It doesn't matter which one. Because a lot of times, if I'm Corey, let's let Adrian do this one. I'm Adrian, okay? And I'd like to have the underhook on it when I do this. I'll let Corey have hand control. He feels good about it. Most guys feel good. You feel good holding something, don't you? And I'll pull it up a little so I can bend my arm if I'm Adrian. I'll mess around Corey a little bit, and I'll just shoot it right past his leg. Why does that work? Corey has hand control. Why does that work? It is a push-pull thing. It's also the difference between can you push more this way or can you control more this way? You can always drive with more or shoot back across for an angle. If I'm pushing this way, most of you guys in this room, I can't stop you from pushing my arm this way if you're driving with your legs and pushing forward. So again, he's right here, Corey. He's feeling good about his situation. Okay, he's got some hand control and stuff. Adrian's got to watch his own leg. Now he's just going to drive across. Right down to the ankle if you can't knee pick it. And as he's driving to the ankle, I really like going that calf ankle with this one. You got to drive up top. You can't reach under. It's because now he's actually taking Corey's power in the center. Corey's not even here anymore. Corey's doing this. Okay? Same thing as Corey doing it back. Doesn't matter who's got the Wizard. Keep the same position. You're Wizarding him. Now do the same thing to Adrian. Less of control here, though, because Adrian still has what when we do it from there? Underhook, right. And he can still start working up. A lot of times work back to his feet. When you have the underhook and you drive, a la St. Pierre does with the knee pick, not the Wizard. Usually he's square when he picks that way. So, yes. Yeah, go, my homie.
When you got this overhook and you're going for the pick, throw this. Throw it through. Like, if I have this here, and I have done this, when I go to pick, I want to get as much of his arm from off my back as possible, get as straight as possible. That way, when I throw, it's kind of...
And hopefully you can go right to where?
Throw it by.
So right to his back.
Yeah, so you grab the ankle, and it's more of a, with the underhook, it's just a drive. I'm taking it up. Yep. With this, I have to throw it, because he's hooked onto me, so when I throw it.
And you follow, guys. Don't just look at your handiwork. The other thing is, too,